over 400 years. So it's like, okay, what could be new again? But after that victory, they said, I will sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. The horse and its rider he has thrown into the sea. The Lord is my strength and song. I'm going to verse 7. And in the greatness of your excellence, you have overthrown those who rose against you. Declare the Lord will overthrow those who rise against us in Jesus' name. Declare it to yourself. Those who rise up against me, the Lord shall overthrow them. Overthrow, overthrow, overthrow. Those that rise against my family, my home, my career, the Lord shall overthrow them. In the mighty name of Jesus, my God shall overthrow them. He said, you set forth your wrath. It consumed them like stubble. So they are now, remember in the story of Jehoshaphat, he was reminding God of what he had done. But this one, they are saying, okay, that this is a present testimony. This is what we see. This is what we can see. It consumed them like stubble. And with the blast of your nostrils, the waters were gathered together. The flood stood upright like a heap. The depths congealed in the heart of the sea. The enemy said, I will pursue, I will overtake, I will divide the spoil. My desire shall be satisfied on them. I want you to declare, the desire of my enemy shall not be satisfied over me in the mighty name of Jesus. The desire of the enemy shall not be satisfied over my children. The desire of the enemy shall not be satisfied over my career, over my life, over my going out and coming in the mighty name of Jesus. The enemy said that they want to satisfy their desire. I will draw my sword. My hand shall destroy them. But said, you blew with your wind. The sea covered them. They sank like lead in the mighty waters. Who is like you, O Lord, among the gods? Who is like you? Glorious in holiness, fearful in praises, doing wonders. You stretch out your right hand. The head swallowed them. You, in your mercy, have led forth the people whom you have redeemed. So the Israelites now, they are now, okay, so you did this. Actually, we didn't know how it was going to happen. But Jehoshaphat did not do that. He just faced God. He did not even, I don't think Jehoshaphat had eye contact with those enemies. He just faced God. But the Israelites, they didn't do anything wrong. They were just now, okay, this thing can be real. We thought the Dead Sea couldn't part. But the Lord has parted it. The Lord has made way for us where there seems to be no way. He made way in the wilderness. And he will make way for us this year in the mighty name of Jesus. So this is where I'm going as I conclude. So in verse 20, he said that then, so this is now after. Remember Jehoshaphat, they sang praise the Lord before. But this is after. Then Miriam the prophetess, the sister of Aaron, took the timbrel in her hand. And all the women went out after her with timbrels and with dances. And Miriam answered them, sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. The horse and its rider he has thrown into the sea. Every horse and the rider pursuing you, even thus far, they shall be thrown into the sea in the mighty name of Jesus. So we have a choice. We have a choice. Starting from today, the first Sunday of the year, to start celebrating, to start being victorious, to start just, they'll be saying, you know, what do you call it? Put your fizzy on. Put your swag on. Whatever they call it, walk confidently, walk with pride. And I'm not saying the proud, walk with pride in Jesus. That when people say, hey, do you know the problem she's going through? And you look at them, that I am like Jehoshaphat. I am not going to look at that battle. I'm not going to look at Amon. I'm not going to look at Seah. I'm looking at Jesus. Looking at the Jesus, the author and finisher of my faith. Because he's the one that frustrates the devices of the crafty. So that their hands cannot carry out their enterprise. You have that choice to be like Jehoshaphat. Or you can be like Miriam and say, okay, the horses are dead. The choicest of Pharaoh's chariots, they are dead. Okay, now I cannot pick my timbrel like Miriam and start dancing around. You have the choice. But either way, God will be glorified. Because he's the one that can do it. He's the one that has been doing it. He's the one that has been defending us. He's been our defense. If God opens our eyes and we can see what is going on in the spiritual, some of us will not even come out from under our comforter. Because we'll be too scared. We'll be too afraid. You won't even know where to put your leg because when you go this way, hey, maybe it is from that angle. But I brought you good news that this year you shall be victorious. Amen. This year you shall be celebrated. Amen. This year you will win. in the mighty name of Jesus. You will win in the morning, you will win in the afternoon, you will win in the evening. In your dreams, you will win. Your children, they will win. No war will overtake you. No war will overcome you. In the mighty name of Jesus, the Lord will make you strong. The Lord will do greater things. The Lord will do new things in your life, in your family, in the mighty name of Jesus. Where you think help has ended, the Lord will begin anew. Where you think it is dry, He will bring water out of it. Where you think the doors are closed, He will open it anew. Where you think it is hopeless, He will do a new thing. Where you think it is all done, the Lord will start afresh for you. In the mighty name of Jesus, let us rise this morning, let us rise this afternoon, and begin to bless the name of the Lord. Father, me, I will praise you like Jehoshaphat. I will praise you before I even see the victories. I will praise you, begin to tell Him what you want to do, or you want to say, God, I will wait like Miriam. Then I will pick my timbrel and start saying, God has done this, I can't see the horses again, and I can't, but faith comes by hearing and hearing by the word of God. I'm not moved by what I see, I'm not moved by what I hear, but I'm moved by the word of God. I'm moved by this wondrous work. I'm moved by His miraculous work. I'm moved by what I'm reminded in God. You have done it before. And you can do it again. You have healed before, and you can heal again. You have made my nothingness to something before. You have made my dryness into an ocean before. And I know you can do it again. So Lord, I will praise you ahead. I will be victorious, and I will be celebrating. Celebrating will fill my home. I will celebrate you in any situation, in any case, anywhere, anyhow. I will celebrate you, Lord Almighty Father, because you are my God. You are my God from the beginning to the end. There is no controversy. Nobody can compare unto you. Nothing compares unto you. Nothing compares unto you, O Lord. I will bless your name. I will not wait until I see the victory, but I will celebrate ahead, because I know I am a winner. I know I am a winner. I will be like Jehoshaphat. I will not wait like Miriam. I will be like Jehoshaphat, and I will bless you, and I will celebrate, and I will sing with loud voices. I will sing with loud voices. I will celebrate. I will dance. I will jump. I will not bother myself about what is going on, but I will face you, Lord. My eyes are upon you, Lord. Thank you, everlasting Father. Glory be to your holy name. Marvelous are you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. Amen. And so, King of Glory, we bless your holy name. We adore you, we worship you, we exalt you, we lift you high. You are God. You are awesome. You are powerful. You've shown yourself mighty before. You've shown yourself excellently before. Where we thought there was no way, you made express there. Now we thought it was a head, you now began afresh from there. So you are God. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. You do not change. Everything could change, but you do not change. And your word is life, your word is powerful. We are reminding you again, Lord, you have done excellently before. You have done mighty things before. You have done miraculous things before. You have brought the dead to life before. And you have seen it even in our time, in our lifetime. So we believe you for 2018 that you will do greater things in Jesus' name. All our expectations shall not be cut short. In the mighty name of Jesus, we shall celebrate this year. In the mighty name of Jesus. And your name alone will be exalted. Your name alone will be glorified. Even as we praise you this afternoon, as we dance, we ask Lord that we accept it ahead in the name of Jesus. And as we are praising you, just like you did for Jehoshaphat, let our enemy begin to ambush themselves. Let them begin to destroy themselves. In